Mike Henning here. I've got another lesson for you today. This time we're going to be talking about transitioning around the neck while in the key of G. So we're going to look at transitioning from our F-shaped G chord up to our D-shaped G chord and then back down. We're also going to look at doing it from open up to our D-shaped G chord and then back down. So very common transitioning that you'll use in backups and lead. I'm going to show you a bunch of different ways to do it. 5 ways to go up and 5 ways to go down. And hopefully you can use these to create your own variations as well. I'm going to break them all down note for note, and here we go. Here's 10 transitions up and down. All right, let's start breaking down this first transition. Let me play it, and then I'll break it down. Let's do that again. Okay, so we're going to start with a 2-5 slide. We're going to start down here, and we're eventually going to get up to our D position G chord up here at the 7th fret. So this is our first transition. We're going to be getting up from an open position up to our up the neck D position G chord. So we're going to start with a 2-5 slide on the 4 string, and we're going to use our third finger, our ring finger of our left hand for this one, because we're basically going to be sliding up into this F-shaped G chord. So we're doing a little thing here where we're using our third finger. That's going to set us up. So even though we're sliding from open, we're kind of pretending that we're going up into this F position G shape. So that's why I'm using my third finger of my left hand there. So we're going to start with a 4 roll strings, 4-3-1, T-I-M with our right hand. That gets us up into position. Then we're going to go up and do another 4 roll, 5-3-1. And then keep that 5th fret down and do strings 4 and 1, TM. So again, you've got... So that'd be a good one to practice. You've probably done that slide with your 2nd finger, your middle finger in the past, which is good when you're playing leads down here. Something like that, but if I was going to slide up... The other thing I could do there is practice going into this chord and just vamping. So that wouldn't be for this transition necessarily, but that'd be a good thing for you to practice. As again, you have to have a smooth way to get up to this F-shaped G chord. And just that slight modification of using your third finger rather than your second puts you in position to get into that chord. See, if I did it this way, wouldn't have any way to get into that shape easily. So that's why I'm using my third finger there. Small detail, but really important. Let's do that one more time. Now right here, I'm gonna slide from 5-9 on the 4th string. That, again, why I'm using my third finger. So I'm getting up into this shape, and then I'm gonna put my first finger on the 7th fret of the 3rd string, 2nd finger, 8th fret, 2nd string, pinky, 9th fret, 1st string. So that's my chord there. And I'm using my third finger, so you don't have to have all those down right away. So that's what we're doing there. Also notice how we're using that slide to help us smooth out that transition. Okay, so practice that as many times as you need to. And that's an 8th note, so it's 1 and. Don't slide too quick. And then right when you're up in that chord, we're gonna do like a little backwards roll. Put your 3rd finger down now on the 9th fret, and then take your 3rd finger off 7th fret, and then back down to the 9th fret on the 4th string. Let's do that real slow. And I'm doing a little thumb index on the same string there. Let's do just the right hand ones. We got thumb, and then middle index, and then thumb index on the 3rd string, and then thumb on the 4th string. So it's... Do that a few times. 1, 2, and 3, and 4. So it's 1, and 2, and 3. Let's put the first two together. One more time, a little faster. Measure 3 is the second half of the transition. This is just once you're up in that position. Now we can do a little roll. So we got 8th fret on the 2nd string, And then a forward roll, string 3-2-1. Back to that second string. And then third string, first string. It's just a little roll you can do when you're up in that position. So the whole thing sounds like this. One more time, a little faster. And remember, what right hand you're doing up there isn't as important as what we're doing with our left hand. Use any of these transition as a jumping off point to your own creativity. So you could use that slide idea, for example, maybe do a different roll once you're up there. You know, you don't have to do the exact right hand I'm doing. That's just a jumping off point to start, you know, thinking of your own ideas. So use any of these things, like I said, as a jumping off point to your own creativity. This is just to get you started. Okay, so one more time, here's transition up number one. Now transition down number one, we're gonna start up in this D-shaped G chord and then get back down to our F-shaped G chord. So we're gonna do a vamp to start it, thumb, and then thumb, index, middle on the top three strings. So stay in that chord. And then we're gonna do an alternating thumb roll, 4-2-3-1. That's just a little roll, so we've got. The other thing you can do is mute those a little bit. And then right here's a little lick. We're gonna hit the open fifth string. And then you're gonna take your second finger and slide from 5 back up to that 8 that you're just on. And then hit that 8th fret again, down to the 3rd string, and we're going to do that thumb index 9-7, and then down to the 9th fret on the 4th string, very similar to the end of measure 2 of transition up. So we basically did something similar. That's a very common Scruggs or J.D. Crow lick. So we've got. Here, you're going to go back down to the 5th fret, and then a little backwards roll, middle, and then thumb index middle, and then 2 more notes, thumb index. And again, the roll's not that important, it's just getting back down there. Once you get back down there, you can do whatever you want. You can do a forward reverse roll, forward roll. We're doing kind of a little partial forward roll there. Let's put all of transition down number one together. Here we go. A little faster. Let's put now transition up and transition down together. Here we go. Okay, so that's a good way to get from your F-shaped G chord up to this D shape and then back down. And we're starting with open, remember, so that's really important because a lot of times you're not always going to be up in this F-shaped G chord. You might be rolling open. And then slide up, remember how we were using our third finger. Really important on this lesson is starting with the correct finger. So remember, our left hand is below the tab. It's the numbers in the circle. So you can refer to the tab if you have any questions on what left hand fingerings I'm using. Now here's lick number 2.